Is it possible to track opportunity with an index? Let's talk about it. Hello, everyone. Welcome to Asset TV. I'm Michelle Yu. Joining me today to break down the Cboe S&P 500 Dispersion Index are Tim Edwards, Head of Index Investment Strategy at S&P Dow Jones Indices, and Mandy Zhu, Head of Derivatives Market Intelligence at Cboe. Thank you both for being with us today. And I want to start with the basics here. What is dispersion and how is it related to market volatility, Mandy?
Thanks, Michelle, for having us here. So dispersion at its core measures how stocks are moving relative to each other. So it is a related but distinct concept from market volatility. You can certainly be in an environment, as we are today, where there is very muted levels of market volatility, but very high levels of single stock volatility as stocks are moving, whether that's based on idiosyncratic factors such as earnings or on thematic factors such as the rise of AI, or on factors such as high inflation, high interest rates. What we're seeing today is a lot of movement at the stock level underneath the index that is not going to be captured by just looking at a market-wide measure of volatility.
Well, Tim, can you describe to me the Cboe S&P Dispersion Index and how exactly it works?
Yeah, sure. So it's a pretty sophisticated index, but the main concept is really simple. The idea is that individual stocks share some risks with each other, the market risk, if you like. And by examining the prices of options on single stocks and options on their combination, i.e. options on the S&P 500, the differences between single stock option prices and index option prices tells us a lot about how differently they're expected to behave. And what S&P did was we collaborated with Cboe, who had rich, deep experience with this, in particular with VIX, right, which is a way to read, if you like, off from the options market an expectation for future volatility. So that technology combined with our index expertise and, of course, using the S&P 500, those were the ingredients. The result, the DSBX or the Dispersion Index, is a 30-day forward-looking or implied indicator how much dispersion is the market pricing in over the next 30 days.
Well, Mandy, what exactly does the Dispersion Index tell us, and how could that data inform market participants?
Sure. I mean, very simplistically, if you're a fundamental investor, equity long short investor, dispersion tells you, or the DSPX index tells you, the opportunity set or the potential alpha that can be generated by stock picking. So think in a high dispersion environment where there's a lot of volatility between stocks, big spreads between the winners and losers. Well, by correctly picking the winners and losers, there's a lot of potential alpha to be generated or P&L to be made in that type of scenario versus a low dispersion environment where the stocks are all kind of moving together similarly. That's perhaps not the best environment for dispersion. So to what Tim had mentioned before, you know, the DSPX index, like the VIX, is a forward-looking measure of dispersion. So it tells you kind of the market expectation of stock picking opportunity of dispersion environment for the next 30 days.
Well, Tim, when you look ahead, broader ecosystem here, what's the role that this index plays?
I think it gives you an extra dimension on risk. For more than 30 years now, VIX has been used as a sort of fear gauge. Where's the balance between greed and fear in U.S. equities? And I think VIX has really become the paramount indicator, but it only tells you one perspective on risk. How much is the whole thing going to move around? Dispersion, which measures how much opportunity there is individually between winners and losers, that's a two-dimensional view on risk that I think can be super important in terms of navigating through things like earnings season. Elections historically have been more about dispersion, winners and losers, than they are about overall market moves. So I think it's that where dispersion really comes in the ecosystem is it's expanding from a single dimensional to a two-dimensional view of where risk is and where's opportunity as well.
I think one of the other questions that people ask is, does the Dispersion Index shed any additional light on the active versus passive debate, Tim?
Does it shed any light? I will say, first of all, I think it gives you a sense. So a high level of the Dispersion Index, high DSBX, what that tells you is the market says there's going to be lots of opportunities for stock pickers. Now, unfortunately, that means opportunity for embarrassment as well as opportunity for glory. In some sense, DSPX tells you these are the current stakes. Very, very low dispersion. Maybe even the greatest stock pickers are not going to be having that great of a time. high dispersion, that tells you there's going to be a big difference between those bets that are good and those bets that could have been better.
Mandy, do you agree? Absolutely. And I love how you put it. It's potential for glory as well as potential for embarrassment. Because as we know, for the past year, it's been very high dispersion type of environment. Yet if you look at active managers, you know, that the P&L obviously is a lot more mixed. And I think that's because, you know, it really depends on you correctly picking the winners versus the losers, as well as just being there's a big spread between the winners and losers.
All right. Well, Mandy and Tim, thank you so much for the discussion. And that will do it for us here on Asset TV. For more information on how indexing works for dispersion and to get the latest research and data on the Cboe S&P 500 Dispersion Index, please visit the link below. I'm Michelle Yu. Thank you so much for watching Asset TV.